China has the power to push Australia in a state of total blackout, and Canberra must kick China out of its power sector. China's hold over Australia has been documented in the aftermath of the coronavirus pandemic, and since then, the relations between the two countries have touched a historic low as threats of trade wars have continuously been perpetuated by Beijing. Earlier, we had reported on how China gained control of Australia's water, and now another sector has emerged in Australia where China has steadily infected the system from inside. Senator Rex Patrick is pushing the Scott Morrison government to conduct a thorough review of Chinese state involvement in Australia's electricity grid and consider the removal of some equipment amid fears of remote sabotage. Some experts have cast doubts about imported Chinese transformers, which could put the power grid under threat of attack. Data from the Australian Bureau of Statistics shows that China has overtaken Vietnam as the main supplier of transformers for the Australian electricity network in recent years. According to a report by Sydney Morning Herald, in 2018 to 2019, Chinese companies supplied 29 of the 70 transformers imported by Australia. Compare this to the 2011 to 2012 data, and you'll notice that China had a minuscule share of the pie back when it only supplied 8 of the 135 transformers imported into Australia, whereas Vietnam supplied 33. The rise in China-sourced transformers has occurred since Beijing's State Grid Corporation bought stakes in electrical transmission network companies SP Ausnet and Electranet, as well as Melbourne-based retailer Jemina. Jemina's executive team features a former deputy mayor of a Chinese city who most certainly would have been connected to the Chinese Communist Party, as holding such official positions in China requires the membership of the CCP. Senator Patrick pointed out this particular instance and asked that proper attention should be paid to the State Grid Corporation representatives on the boards and in the executive ranks of its Australian electricity companies. Of the 29 transformers supplied to Australia in the year 2018 to 2019, 16 were put for use in Australia. It is imperative to note that the Victorian government is taking a diametrically opposite stance from that of Morrison's party in centre and pushing for the controversial Belt and Road Initiative in the region. Victoria's BRI project is being increasingly described within Australia as a strategic blunder, and rightly so. The project has major foreign policy repercussions for Canberra. Even the United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo recently said that the United States wouldn't hesitate to disconnect from Australia if Victoria's BRI project threatens its telecom security. That being said, Australia's increasing reliance on Chinese machinery, especially the transformers, has raised the fear index about Australia's electricity grid's vulnerability, which is prone to foreign interference. Cybersecurity expert Paul Dabroa said it was possible for a foreign government to badly damage Australia's electricity grid within 2 minutes. He said, "It could take months to repair the damage. There's open source material about experiments that have proven this is possible." The Western security agencies, and in particular America, fear that foreign-built transformers could have malicious electrical components surreptitiously installed that could potentially allow another country to interrupt power supply on a whim. In May, US President Donald Trump issued an executive order to place tight restrictions on the use of foreign-sourced equipment in the electricity grid because of rising fears about the possibility of remote attacks and sabotage. As Senator Patrick's demands started appearing in media channels, the CCP mouthpiece Global Times also published an article and meekly insinuated that if Australia went down the same path as the US, then it wouldn't turn out well for its citizens. The article read, "By following the US, Australia is also risking the interests of ordinary households as China's expertise in electricity provision and grid system upgrades can help reduce their high running costs. This veiled threat should indeed be taken seriously if the real-life example of the Philippines is anything to go by. According to news reports, the Philippines' power grid is under the full control of the Chinese government and could be shut off in the time of conflict." An internal report prepared by the lawmakers of the country had warned last year, stating, "Our national security is completely compromised due to the control and proprietary access given by the local consortium partner to the Chinese government." Just like Rex Patrick, another senator in the Philippines last year had sent the warning bells ringing when he said, "With a single switch, no electricity would be transmitted to any of our homes or businesses or any of our military facilities." Recently reported by TFI, it had also emerged that China had got itself a major chunk of Australia's water bodies, which in turn were starving the Australian farmers, as the monopoly over the water bodies meant that water was being sold to the farmers at exorbitantly high prices. With China gaining unparalleled control of Australia's water and electricity, the Xi Jinping regime has the required ammo to cripple the Aussies. So far, there hasn't been any electricity grid attack in humankind history, but it is theoretically possible, and given the relations between Canberra and Beijing, the Scott Morrison government cannot take any half chances. The Foreign Investment Review Board, which had strengthened its regulations in the wake of the Chinese threat after the pandemic, needs to tighten the screws around the national security grid deals too. Otherwise, if such tenders are given unchecked to the Chinese, the Australians will be at a disadvantage during times of conflict. Losing electricity and losing water in today's modern globalized world can cut Australia off from the world. From stealing of medical equipment to imposing tariffs on barley to gaining control of Australia's water bodies and to monopolizing the electricity grid, China has done it all to turn Australia upside down. Consequently, Scott Morrison needs to pay heed to Senator Patrick's advice and make the necessary amends.